Oh, hey there, everybody. This is Matty G back here again to do another episode of Let's Play Indie Games. And today, I'm going to be playing a game that I've been looking forward to for a long time called Where the Water Tastes Like Wine. So, if you don't know what this game is,
night has fallen and you're weary from travel. Stars fill the sky.
It's essentially like a story driven game, kind of like the Telltale.
Wooden house. Only building you've seen
series
for
of games
days.
It interested me because I love the Telltale games, and I also like the art style that they have here in this game. But before we get started, I need to get some Tina in me, so now that I've got a little bit of Tina, let's make this thing happen. So I was interrupting this guy. He said, night has fallen and you're weary from travel. Stars fill the sky above, and in front of you is a brightly lit wooden house, the only building you've seen for days.
You walk toward the house, hearing the sounds of laughter and talk as you reach the door and push it open.
All right. I guess that's me, the faceless man with the knapsack.
You sit down and join the game. It's a cheap buy-in, and not many of the other players are very good. The lady fiddling with dice gets good cards, but has no real strategy. The man to your right seems to just hold on to the highest cards he has, regardless of suit or any consideration of matches.
Well, who else is here?
The man in gray across from you, though. He's good. He already had the largest pile of coins when you bought in. And while your winnings grow quickly, you can't quite catch him. One by one, the other players leave the table. Sometimes with pique or with wry humor, leaving their winnings with you or the man in gray.
If this is the man in gray, he appears to have a serious either birth defect or a weird thing going on where he's literally wearing the head of a wolf. But, you know, we'll figure that out as we go. My cards are amazing.
Finally, it's just you and the man in gray. He looks at you, full of humor, and winks. Last hand?
Yeah, I'm in.
He deals, you draw, and look at your hand. It's good. It's great. The best hand, in fact. A royal straight flush.
Ace high.
High.
Nothing can beat me.
But
I like this announcer.
Pushes forward his whole pile. You're not sure exactly.
Or narrator, not
is,
announcer.
But it's more than you've got. You can't match that.
I really like this clicky sound. Any? Yeah, I like that. So I guess I'm gonna fold my unbeatable hand.
The man in gray stops you. Now, if you like, I'll let you wager your word. I know you'll be good for it.
Well, I'd like to wager my word, but I'm also interested in checking my cards, considering we almost folded literally the perfect hand. I'm gonna see what made me change my mind. I guess this is significant. This is our first real choice.
Yep. 10, jack, queen, king, ace. All spades.
Okay, so we have a perfect hand. You have my word.
The man in gray smiles. All right, then. I'll call.
There's a crow outside my window. And it is just just yelling nonstop. I think. Yeah, no, that's outside. Or maybe those are geese. Those are probably the geese that are always out there.
Well, your luck wasn't so good, was it? That's quite the hand, but not for the game we're playing.
So somehow my hand was not at all what I saw. Sure.
But more than that, your labor.
Okay, Mr. Wolf.
You see, this land is built on stories. It's one big story, this country, woven of many small ones. Few of the small ones are strictly true, and the big story is mostly a lie.
Oh, I like this music. Reminds me of Red Dead. And I really do love some Red Dead.
All the stories and songs and myths and legends start somewhere, with a seed. As they're told and retold and passed around, they grow and change to become the stories we know. To pay your debt to me, you'll be carrying stories, finding the seeds first and then spreading them, telling them onwards so they can begin gaining strength. This is no light task. Stories are heavy.
I wonder what this wolf is supposed to symbolize.
Most of the stories you'll find will be small seeds. They might be true, but they'll grow wild and unbelievable with the telling. The more important stories are the true ones. The ones people will tell you about their own lives. Those often get lost in the weaves of the big story. The more true stories you can find and tell, the more you can weave that truth into the big story. Tarnish it a bit, perhaps, but isn't a dingy and battered truth better than a shining lie?
I'm not sure there's a difference.
Go ahead. You tell me a story. I'll trade you some information about your task.
Alright, so we got 3, 4, 5 stories that we can tell, and many other stories that we could unlock. So let's see what we got here. Death, change, endings, moving on, fortune, fate, and luck. Heaven, desires fulfilled, wishes come true, choice, morality, and travel. Well, I like the Wheel of Fortune here. I like the show Wheel of Fortune. That's a great show. And I'm also, big believer in the concept of luck. So let's go with this story. Okay, so when you click on these, they each have their own little thing. Tell the story of tossing a pair of bone dice on a blood red velvet table. They come up snake eyes and wink at you.
It's just luck. Funny how bad luck seems to follow the folks who already have problems aplenty.
Show enough.
Well, try your luck out there in this country. See how the dice treat you.
All right.
It's not all bad. You'll have to work hard, but I'll give you the gift for seeing the true shapes of people.
Interesting.
Not many who can do that.
Okay, so I guess we are choosing more than one. I will go with the tower, I guess. Tell the story of a black and gray city where every building is filled with desiccated corpses. Alright, let's check it out. Let's see what goes on with this selection.
I'll strip away your flesh to make the journey easier, but still you will feel pain.
Alright.
Hunger, weariness, thirst, and despair. They're all part of stories, the part not often told. And death, yes, but don't worry. As long as your task remains, you come back.
So is he, am I immortal at this point? Just because, he said as long as the task remains, the task I'm doing for him, I'll come back. Maybe if I die, I am reincarnated. And this is a game Right, so that's just kind of how it works. I guess we're choosing more stories. We'll do Justice. Tell the story of endless series of doors of different kinds, each leading only to more doors. Okay, alright, we'll do.
You sometimes have to
I really love this artwork, though. Kind of story it's hand-drawn.
Is it a love
book.
Story?
Or I mean, I'm sure it is hand-drawn, but you get what I'm saying.
Don't gather too many of one kind, though. This grand story needs variety.
Okay, so maybe we're just selecting every story. That we would have, you know, like a choice. The world. This one is tell the story of the parting of a cloud of fog to reveal a brief glimpse of a land of promise and plenty.
Your deepest desires, your greatest wish, heaven, big rock, candy mountain, El Dorado, the promised land. That place just over the ridge where they all say that the water tastes just like the sweetest
wine. Oh, weaving the title in. The promised land.
Well, I don't know where that is.
Well, I guess we'll find out.
It's supposed to be somewhere in this country. Ask the people you meet. They're all searching for the same thing.
Alright, last one, the Traveler. Tell the story of the northbound train blinking its giant eye as it crawls through the night.
Travel? That's your job. Wander from place to place, gather those stories and spread them. People get bored hearing the same stories over and over. But an old cliche in one state might be a rip-roaring new yarn in another. Go on your way, Seeker. Maybe we'll meet again, or maybe not.
All right.
Either way, it'll be an experience for you. I'm jealous in some ways. I hope you find what you're looking for.
I'm not even quite sure what I'm looking for. Oh, okay. I am now a big walking skeleton? I guess I could just go wherever. I guess I'll follow the trail. We can follow the trail. Do, 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 do. How do I do this? I'm just gonna guess spacebar. And it is spacebar.
There's furniture piled in the front yard.
Ammunition heaped under the mailbox. And a crowd of clean-cut men ripping apart a car in the driveway. So my only answer to this is strange. Okay.
The two heavily armed, mud-caked women leaning over the porch railing share the same bored grin. One shouts at you.
Lend a couple innocent gals a cigarette?
I don't know, they don't sound innocent. I could give it to them so that they don't murder me. No, I'm just gonna see what Noah's gonna end up doing.
One of the women wrinkles her nose in disappointment. The other raises a rifle, levels it at you, and shouts, "Bang!" A couple of the men come to take the guns away. Keep that up. We'll move this party down to the station, one snaps.
Okay, alright. Oh, women arrested for bootlegging. Alright. US-Canada border? Can I go to Canada? Okay, now I just want to know if it'll let me go. I know this is supposed to take place in the United States, so... Oh, no. Nope, Canada. No coverage for you here. When the night comes down, for to take me hand in hand, this will be my tale, my vagrant song. This will be my tale. wish I could move faster. I wonder if there's a way for me to move faster. It does not appear that there's a way. Kind of got this set up weird. I really need to change where my keyboard is.
Off the road and into the woods, you can't help but come across this package by the old tree tied to a sturdy stick. The cloth wrapping conceals, though not particularly well, something large and softly unsettled.
Little eyes blink back at you from inside the bundle. Oh, well, surely we don't want to move on yet. Let's say hello to this thing.
The shape gives a start.
Please don't tell my pa that I'm in here.
It says in a small voice.
Why not?
Pa doesn't want to live with us anymore. But I want to go with him. Don't tell him, please. I'm hiding.
There's nothing around this place. You know what? I think normal me would not tell, because I feel bad for this thing, child, whatever it is. I'm curious where his dad is.
His father must have been here at some point, but you sure can't see him now.
Please go. He's coming back any minute,
says the boy, growing agitated.
He's gonna see you talking to me. Please, go!
He only calms down when you leave. You don't see another soul for miles.
Huh. Okay, well, we will move on. Oh, I'm going this way, I think. Portland. Oh, Portland, Maine. I guess that's maybe a nice place. I have no idea. I'm going to go to Portland, Oregon here in a couple weeks. So I'm, yeah, that sounds fun. I like the day-night cycle going on here. Let's check out what's going on in Portland.
They don't come every year, you know. The old man is sitting at the edge of a rotting old pier, crooked legs dangling over the water. He watches a pair of seagulls preen and groom each other on a rock just off the shore. Just when the fishing is going to be good. He taps great, black, thick globs of spent tobacco out of a huge ceramic pipe. We got another year, I guess.
That is the only reasonable question. One more year of what?
Another year of this town being here, he replies, letting a grin spread across his face. If the seagulls came, that means enough fish to keep it in place.
Okay. Interesting.
The woman walks the small town square with the poise of Betty Davis. A confident stride and inimitable mannerisms elevating the sidewalk into a plush Hollywood carpet.
Man, I really love this artwork.
Wrapped around her neck, yellow velvet ribbon, bright as an ocean sunrise.
All right, let's ask around about her, I guess.
You question a well-dressed man parked outside an oyster house. Prudish woman. I took her on a fine date, and she didn't remove so much as a ribbon. Excuse me, can you step back from the coop? That's the spirit. You decide to seek a second.
So, this guy was, she was looking for a real date relationship, and he was just, you know what, we just won't go into that. Anyway, let's ask around more about this lady.
You talk with a waitress smoking outside a diner.
Something funny.
Just
showed up one day. Doesn't work, doesn't live anywhere as far as I know. Just around. Myself, I'd love to know who made all their beautiful clothes.
Same. So I can ask around more, or I can approach the woman. I don't know which woman. I am currently talking to a woman. Maybe they're talking about the woman. Okay. I'm going to try to approach the lady. Let's try. I can't even talk right now. Let's give it a shot.
You ask the woman if you may join her at a public bench.
You may. Lovely outside, isn't it?
Her eyes are a beautiful shade of brown. Beneath the yellow ribbon, a thick, fibrous scar wraps around her throat.
Was it like this? It reminds me of Paris.
So she is a foreign. Wait, this is it. That's it. We're gonna leave right now. I want to know more about this lady. All right. Well, on we go to the next thing.
You can see storm clouds on the horizon, and you don't relish the thought of being caught wandering this rocky seaside road in the rain. Fortunately, you find the lighthouse door open with a daunting staircase before you.
All right, well, let's climb up. That's what I do.
At the top of an ornate wrought iron spiral, you're breathless and feeling the strain on your knees.
Rain already batters the walls outside. You can only knock on a heavy wooden door leading into the upper level. Muffled voices seep in beneath the door. I don't know if I could do it. I think he did better than me.
Looks like we got a visitor. Sounds like a man's voice, deep and rough.
Well, behave yourself. I'll open the door. Doo-doo.
Man, I love this music too.
This one with a higher, more
I wish there were more space. Options. I gotta say.
Behave myself. He feigns indignation, but his tone betrays affection instead.
All right.
After a moment, the door unlatches from the inside and opens. The man before you is tall and muscular,
with a hint of paunch beneath his wide chest.
The heavy iron knob on the door looks nearly dainty in his huge hand.
Didn't want to be out in this rain, did you? Come in.
Oh man, the narration is a little slow.
Despite the rough exterior,
this room looks like a well-appointed parlor.
There's a rug on the well-trod wooden floor, and an enormously plush couch. And sat upon it is a stocky fellow grinning through
hazel-colored beard.
Tea? Yeah. He offers, hoisting a teapot.
All right, so we've got an option again here. Been here long, or it must be lonely up here. I assume these options tailored the outcome of the story that you gain from these experiences. Let's do it must be lonely up here. See what we get out of it.
Oh, we manage.
The tall one sits on the sofa, casually wrapping an arm around the other lighthouse keeper.
The quiet suits us just fine.
He needs his quiet time. He's a writer. The tall one grunts.
I dabble, but you must have some good stories from the road.
Oh, okay, hey. Maybe I'll get an opportunity to tell one of the stories.
You wake up the next morning on their old sofa, still warm from an excess of tea.
No.
And
okay.
Cakes? There might have been little cakes.
Little cakes?
Prodigious snoring rumbles in from the floor above you.
You quietly take your leave. Alright, let's move on then. So one thing I've noticed is I have at least gained a story from each of these places I've been to. Looks like we're on the border of New Hampshire and Maine. Let's see. Oh, I can do it! Yeah. Cool. Does it just take me to the next city? I guess so. Alright, cool. It's interesting. Alright, so we have have some options here. We can go to the store with the no money I have. But if we had money, we could get apple cider, clam chowder, coffee, iced coffee. It looks like maybe if you have money, you can use that to increase your health, maybe, and your sleep, I guess. I guess that's what ZZ means. Red brick, green trees, blue sky, and this weather, Boston is beautiful, that is, until you make your way deeper into the city and get lost among the cramped, winding, shadow-haunted old streets. Okay, well, while we're here in the shadow-haunted streets, let's give a shot at earning money, or take a shot, that's a better word. You wander the streets of the city looking for a way to make some cash, I can either beg for it, or beg for it in a different way. So, I guess I'll look for work. Small terrier rushes out on the sidewalk. Here, you, she says. Won't you watch him for me? He keeps chewing the shoes, and it'll only be a minute. Okay, I'll watch the dog. Thank you. Okay, I just got something. Thank you, she cries and heads inside again. The terrier seems perfectly content in your arms until she returns and scoops him up, leaving you with a very generous tip. Move on. Oh, I got the dollars now. Okay, let's explore, I guess.
This city is like no other you've been to.
Crooked splay streets, out into a maze of narrow passages.
No two alike. Soon, you find yourself in twilight, utterly lost. Bright light crests around one corner. A car approaching.
I guess. You know, I'm gonna keep walking. Maybe. This is a hard decision for me. You know what? There's got to be a story in the taxi, right? Let's do that.
Compelled by the cold and foreboding night, you don't question it as you drag your bones into the cab. But you realize immediately how strange the vehicle is. It's a sleek thing, like a shallow parabola gliding over the street.
Huh, yeah, that would be a weird car. Parabola-shaped car would be odd. It's like the like the only thing I can think of right now is the Cars and what was the name of that movie? The one with the minions. Despicable Me. Yeah, there you go.
Where to? He asks. You have to stop and think. Eventually. You name Boston Common, the only landmark you know in this town. He peels off silently. You feel the car move before you hear the
engine. Let's look out the window.
He takes you through ever odder streets, flanked by painfully clean, gleaming buildings and signage for businesses you don't recognize. Even the air seems different.
Gasoline and coal. I guess.
Eventually.
Harvard. All right, let's pay him.
The fares in glowing numbers above his dashboard.
Ooh, no charge.
Surely a mistake. No charge. He insists. You look like you need a break. And then you find yourself.
You know, I don't. I've been in a lot of taxis. I don't know of any taxi that would do that. Maybe it's the only taxi driver I can think of that would do that is what's his name? Alex Riga from the show Taxi. Maybe. Even he's got to make some money though. News story, the odd silent taxi, and I missed it. Okay, train station. We could go to New York or Detroit. Maybe we'll do that in a second. I wanna go to this last guy over here. Oh, right. W A SD keys are for moving, not up, down, left, right.
A dusty truck and a man on horseback pull up next to one another in front of the grocer. Suddenly, the driver and the rider, two wiry old men with identical haircuts, start shrieking at one another.
Ooh, what's going on, boo-boo?
The man with the truck leaps into the street.
Brother!
He shouts. The one on the horse tumbles out of his saddle.
Brother!
He screams. They embrace in the road.
32?
30 years.
Oh. No, not 32. Okay, I can read.
The rider. Tears streaming.
All right, we're just going to click Oh Wow, we get it. He's watching these two older men cry.
Middle of Main Street. Cars and wagons are backing up. People are yelling.
Take a photo of us.
The driver begs you. Starts hauling a tripod out of the bed.
So we should probably get out of the road, right? I don't want to say cheese and then have one of them get obliterated by a car. I'm gonna suggest.
As you usher them onto the sidewalk, the driver says,
Joe, I thought you were dead.
The rider freezes.
Joe?
He blurts.
I'm not Joe.
The two men stare at one another.
What?
Each slowly recognizing something alien in their mistaken brother's face.
Okay. So somehow both of these guys lost their brother 30-ish years ago. And now they realize neither of them are their brother. Interesting. Okay. Well, I unfortunately am going to have to stop for now, but I'll be back pretty soon. Well, you know, in the future. Anyway, yeah, so if you want to watch more of me playing this interesting game, to say the least, then make sure to subscribe, and if you really want to know, click that little bell button by the subscribe button, and, you know, you'll always know if I'm playing games. I can get words out. I'll figure it out how to use my words. And if you're feeling real generous, head over to the Patreon and make sure that I keep playing these games forever and ever and ever and making these videos anyway. Thanks for watching, guys. I will see you next time.